If you've seen our other video on infinity cubes here on It Came From China, you might recognize that we've looked at these before in the post-spinner craze and had a look at infinity cubes. In this video, we're going to look at a slightly more expensive one, so stick around to see if it's worth the difference and how it compares to the cheaper one that we bought before. Welcome everybody to another great episode with It Came From China. And we've looked before at infinity cubes on this channel, and we've looked at these cheaper ones in particular that cost $1.87 for this plain colored one. And we've seen that it worked generally well overall, a little bit noisy though, and a tiny bit stiff for the plain color one. And the colorful ones we saw had quite a few different troubles. Things are sticky and don't work quite as well. The paint sort of scratches itself and comes off and so on. So this time around, we went for a more expensive one, and let's have a look at the difference. Let's see if it's worth the extra spend, what the price was, how it compares, and so on. Now, I don't really usually show you the bubble wrap, but the item arrived yesterday, and it came this time in a box. These just came plainly in an envelope. I wanted to show you the bubble wrap, though, because I was unpacking it yesterday, getting ready to throw the bubble wrap away, and I happened to notice stuck inside there is a nice little extra gift. And it shouldn't really influence the overall review of the product, but certainly can't be too upset to get an extra little gift in there. It's a little kind of green character keyring here. I think it's a Monsters, Inc. character, something like that. But nice little extra gift to get in the container. Now, price-wise, this was around $4.50. I think I paid a tiny bit less on one of the sales. It's now about $5.70, something like that. So quite a bit different to the $1.87. If you're buying a whole bunch of these, maybe you want to give them away as gifts to kids or an event or something like that, you might want to go with the cheaper ones. But certainly this one is quite a bit more expensive. But let's have a look at the overall difference. Now, packaging-wise, it came a little bit squashed, so that's something to be aware of in terms of depending on what you want to do with it, but really not too bad. And it's got some details on here and what you can use it for and how you can play with it and so on. Not really too much. There is some detail on the back of the different colors, and I kind of chose the color I want, so I'm happy with that. Let's go ahead and open it up. Now, inside, curiously enough, the box is mostly empty. It's quite a big box for quite a small cube. But nevertheless, let's have a look at it without anything falling on the floor there. And we do see quite a difference straight away. The actual join items are different colored. These are all black, whereas these ones on this model, they're always a different color to the main cube. In this case, they're gray versus the black. So there's a color difference, but I'm not too fussed about that. There's an overall size difference, so the cubes themselves are about the same, but the little hinges, if you like, are quite a bit bigger on this one, and everything's very well rounded. This one, everything's quite sharp corners, which I don't think is necessarily a problem. You're unlikely to spike yourself in the eye with this, but the difference seems to be immediately as you start to play with it. Everything's a lot looser. And flows a lot better. There's definitely a much higher quality bar in this one. And I think part of that is because of the rounded corners. Nothing sort of catches itself in the same way. And everything, as I said, flows a little easier. It does seem to be a little quieter, so I'm going to play with it. Look, it is a bit of a noisy toy. You're going to hear some clicking and some clacking and so on. But it seems to be a little bit quieter than this one overall. The wife actually had a notice of that and felt also that this one was a little quieter, which is important in the overall peace and quiet in the home. But if you're going to use this at work, in meetings with colleagues or at school, something like that, you might be sensitive to that as well. So it's another thing to be aware of in terms of the overall difference. I find this one a lot easier to play with and a lot looser. I'm certainly happy with the extra spend on this. You might want to wait for a special. As I said, it's now $5.70. Maybe wait till one of the AliExpress specials till it's $4.50 again, or look around at different sellers, for example. But overall, definitely a big quality difference compared to the other one. I'll enjoy both, and I'll maybe keep the one as a spare for different scenarios, you know, one at home, one at work, one in the car, that kind of thing, as much as one needs multiple infinity cubes. If the spinner craze is anything to go by, we'll probably have multiple of these going around as well. So overall recommendation, price-wise, definitely a lot more. Look, it was $4.50, so it's not going to break the bank, but it's certainly, you know, three or four times more, whatever, depending on how much you end up paying for this compared to the other one. So you've got to decide whether you're happy with that difference. I would say not too bad, but certainly quite a bit more, but I feel like I'm getting a higher quality product overall. So quality-wise, definitely much better on this one. And then packaging, well, it came in a box, came nicely packaged. I'd be much more comfortable giving this as a gift, for example. But as I mentioned, just be aware that the box might have come a little bit dented and damaged when it arrives to you. So it's not too bad to give as a gift, but you might be a little bit more concerned about that. It could have been a little bit better, better wrapped. So it is what it is. As always, though, your chinage may vary. So as I've found with variations, even in this one, some of these came better than others. This one definitely seems to be better quality, though, so probably going to be okay overall. So should you chuck it, should you check it, or should you go ahead and charge it? I would say you may want to check it. You may not want to spend the extra. Maybe, as I said, you're buying a whole bunch of gifts or something like that. So if you're buying just for you and you're happy to spend the extra money, you might be willing to charge it. But really, it's more of a check it scenario in this case. Now, if you're interested in this particular item, of course, I'll put a link up in the video notes down below that you can go ahead and check out to go ahead and buy this product. If you've enjoyed the video, though, be sure to give us a thumbs up, as always, and subscribe to our channel to get great weekly reviews of what we've been buying from China. Make sure to hit the little alarm bell when you sign up as well to get those notifications straight into your inbox. Thanks for watching.